After 3 days in Khabarovsk, we continued to hitchhike to Vladivostok. The first driver picked us up for 70 kilometers and he invited us for tea. From this place is just 10 kilometers to the China, to the border with China. This cup says us, follow your dream.
This man Ivan picked us up for 300 kilometers. It's like almost half of the way from Khabarovsk to Vladivostok. We go to Vladivostok, 200 kilometers with Igor.
Today is the middle of September, and yesterday in the evening we arrived to Vladivostok, and our couchsurfing host Dima took us to see Russian island, Ostrov Russky. From here we see the Japanese sea. The weather is really nice because a few days before it was rainy and cold, and 2 weeks ago in this area was typhoon, the strongest since last 50 years. So we are really lucky with the weather. Maybe it's still possible to swim because the water should be still warm.
This is the Japanese sea, view from the island Russky, Russian island. And we go this way. In 1986, in this direction, the submarine exploded. And since this time, the level of radiation here is a little bit higher than normal. Just a month ago, in this place, we all boards, so from where you can jump the sea, but now we took it off. These are people from Korea, but you can still jump off this edge of the cliff. 11 meters. And we saw people jumped with parachutes. The water isn't so cold actually, maybe 18, 19 degrees. So it's possible to swim. Кто же еще покормит нуждающихся лис, как не Дима? Они, походу, у себя прикормленные уже. Хотя нет, она свалила в кусты. To the place from where you can walk to the lighthouse Takaretskaya Koshka, Takaretskaya Cat. So this is kind of the beach, and from the parking place to the lighthouse is only 700 meters walk. And this is the Russky Most Russian Bridge. Golden Gate Bridge is this way. In Vladivostok a lot of hills, so a lot of peaks which we will visit in another day.
In Vladivostok I found Eduard on couchsurfing. He we stayed with Dmitry, but Eduard invited us to into his sauna. And this is the table. This is Russian food.
Вареники, homemade пельмени. And this is the vegetables from the village. Potato with meat. Here we have a billiard.
This is a swimming pool. And this is sauna. Actually, typical Russian sauna is a banya, but this is actually sauna. It's not banya. And Eduard hitchhiked from Vladivostok to Moscow in 21 days, 2 years ago. So he is like our travel soul. And he also hosted a lot of travelers at his home in Vladivostok. After 7 years, Eduard plans to travel around the world. Also by hitchhiking and different types of transport. today is our second day in Vladivostok, and we started to walk on the pedestrian street called Arbat from the city center all the way down to the beach. And here we found the monument of the shrimp and also the sign "I love Vladivostok", but this sign is not so colorful. I think there is some better version of the same thing in the city. So all this place is the beach, and I guess the level of the sea went up now, so it's not much space, sand space here. This is the view from the hill. I see there is a place with the swimming pool, an open air gym, nice benches, and I see at least 4 people are swimming right now. The first time in Russia I see capsule photo. First time, and in Vladivostok, Zodiac. I thought it's popular only in Asia. This is Victory Square of Vladivostok. Behind me is a Golden Gate Bridge, Russian version. This is Spaso-Preobrazhensky Cathedral, and here there is a monument for the fighters of power of Soviet Union on the Far East in 1917-1922. This is the Ocean Prospect, and here you can see this monument of hitchhiker. Actually, this is the sailor, and he's hitchhiking. And on this street, quite a beautiful architecture. In Vladivostok, a lot of things written also in Chinese, Japanese and Korean languages, because in this city a lot of people from these countries, a lot of tourists and also people who moved to Vladivostok from these countries. One more sightseeing, it's art from 1880, and this is the theater of dolls, or doll theater, or puppet theater, I don't know exactly. And this is the building of bank. This is the monument for the ships which died in different times in the sea, in the ocean. And this is the Golden Gate Beach. This is another part of the monument. This is embankment of Tsarevich, and this is again Golden Bridge. Right next to this modern building, you can find burnt abandoned house and some old houses. This is cable car which operates from 7 a.m. till 8 p.m. It costs just 20 rubles and you can get the nice view of the city. The glass beach. There are two of the most famous beaches in the world. One is near San Francisco in California, and one is here near Vladivostok. A couple of weeks ago, at the beginning of September, in Vladivostok was very strong typhoon storm, so a lot of glass moved this way, another glass moved in the sea, and also a lot of glass was taken by the Chinese tourists. So now it's only narrow line with glass, but before all the beach was like this. Now it looks quite dirty. And I will try to swim now, because since I'm here by the Japanese Sea, I have to swim here. The water is okay, but it's a little bit windy. And these people in the white car were celebrating the wedding here on this beach. Biggest concentration of glass here, but it's not that big. I thought it would be more colorful. not the cold country. I will swim in the sea right now. It's 18th of September and this is my second time to swim in the sea.
Crazy girl. This is a changing room on the glass beach. It's also written here in Chinese. And next to it, there is free toilet and free shower as well. So you can wash yourself after salty water and be clean again. This is resort in the Soviet Union style. It reminds me children's camp, summer camp, these houses. Memories of my childhood. Dima said 1.5 months ago the bridge was normal, but now it's broken. There are different places for tourists, cafe, hotels, entertainment. A few years ago, Dima worked on the ships as a mechanic, and he studied in the special university. Linoleum inside of the captain room. Dima said actually this ship is in quite good condition considering it's from North Korea. It's not a big ship. I don't know how old. Probably they dried some fish or sea food here. I don't know how many people it can fit. And North Korea is fishing in the Russian waters because food is allowed. This is CouchSurfer. In the furthest destination of our trip, Dima, and he is our couchsurfing host number 8 in this trip. Dima also traveled by hitchhiking. He crossed all Russia 2 years ago.
Yes.
From Vladivostok all the way to Moscow, St.Petersburg and Crimea Peninsula. And he hosted a lot of hitchhikers. He knows a lot of travelers like I do. 7 years ago, he worked on the ships and was cruising around, but now he changed for the regular work in the city. So this is apartment which rents Dima for 25,000 rubles per month. And actually the prices in Vladivostok almost the same like in Moscow. Dima provided us this room with this bed. He prefers to sleep on the floor because it's better for the back. And this is like local art because this area of Russia, this part of Russia is famous with its tigers and bears and so on. Today is 20th of September and this is the view on Vladivostok from the hill Kristovskaya Sopka. This is Golden Bridge. It was built in 2012. This is the coil. They spray the water all the time to put the dust down, to keep the dust down. And this is the lighthouse Takarevskaya Koshka. This is the lighthouse Takarevskaya Koshka. And in this place, road trips from Moscow to Vladivostok finished. This is names of members of this event and their cars. But to walk to the lighthouse, you have to take your shoes off. This is another hill called Eagle Nest. A couple of days before we were on this viewpoint. From here is nice view on the Golden Bridge, but because of these buildings,
it's not so visible.
After 6 days in Vladivostok, we came to Nakhodka. It was quite easy to hitchhike. A taxi driver picked us up for free. So the whole trip took us 3 hours, and now we are walking 2 kilometers to the better spot for hitchhiking, like at the exit and the end of the road from Nakhodka. And this is how houses look here, the buildings, typical Soviet Union style. And around this area there are hills. We go to some beach and harbor, nice place to hang out, also with 3 lakes with fresh water. It's just 35 kilometers from this place. The last 10 kilometers to the place with 3 lakes. We came to the place Triazerie, it means 3 lakes. It's 40 kilometers from Nakhodka. The lakes are in this direction, behind guest houses and camping. We came with this guy Marat, he has a free day today. He actually had another plans, but after he decided to join us and come to this place with us. This beach is quite clean and the water is clean. 21st of September, but the water is still warm, so I think I will go and swim now. Yeah, and the area is just beautiful, it has hills and nice green colors. Much more clean compared to Vladivostok beaches.
А, вон какая-то вода. Полуловки, да? Я не знаю, мне кажется.
Свадьбу приеду, сейчас напишу.
This is Cape of Plashkevich number 2. This is like wild beach. People come here for barbecue, for fishing, and you can camp here for free. Behind this cliff is Cape of Plashkevich number 1. This is hill sister. And behind this hill is Cape of Plashkevich number 3. This place is quite peaceful and clean. And there is also nice forest around. Mm-hmm. Съела? Нет. Но ест, по-моему, да? Mm-hmm. This is little fox, baby fox. Mm-hmm. Our driver Marat brought us to some viewpoint, and from here we can see the whole city Nakhodka. It's already evening lights, very beautiful. Time is almost 8 p.m. but still everything is visible and has some lights. I think this is quite expensive houses in this area because it has nice view.
This is Nakhodka in the evening. It's not a big city, but it's long. Because it was built along the sea line. It also has many harbors. In addition, when Marat picked us up, he also invited us to stay at his place. This apartment he rents since a couple of weeks. He will stay here for a couple of months while he works near Nakhodka. So this is typical one-room apartment from Soviet Union times. We will sleep like we sleep while we are camping. So this is how it looks usually. The bathroom is very small. Like Soviet Union style carpet. Новобятский механический завод. Да, все из Советского Союза.
Бич-вариант.
Да нет, более-менее нормально. So, the rent of this apartment costs just 13,000 rubles plus electricity and water. It's the cheapest version.
cheapest apartment to rent. But it's actually quite cozy and nice. Even the carpets, but the owner took it out from the wall and from the floor. We are hiking already to the hill sister. We left our backpacks with people which stay at the house on the parking lot. So the trail isn't hard, looks like this. But of course now we go uphill, so it's kind of steep. But the views from here are quite nice. It took us 35 minutes to come to the top of the hill sister. The height is approximately 312 meters and it's really worth it to come here because from here we can see 360 degrees panorama and the view on the whole city of Nakhodka. But a lot of flying bugs here which try to bite us, it's horrible. Yesterday in the evening we were on these beaches with driver Marat. So to come from the main road to the beginning of the trail is just 2.5 kilometers. But we were lucky because the man brought us directly to the parking lot. And the people told us a few years ago we cut the top of this hill for the mining or something, and after this climate changed in this area. Way down was a little bit easier because we found the way how to go on the beach. We left our backpacks inside this house and this is parking lot. It costs 200 rubles, but now I don't know, maybe it's for free or only for the visitors of this resort. Small place, it's like village, 10 kilometers from the Vatia. Totally asphalt. Parts of this road is dirt road, but it's still okay. Not much traffic in this to this place, to this village. This is another view on the harbor and sea. The view from somebody's garden. And there is also this cliff with funny trees. Looks like head with hair. This is the beach in Livadia. Actually now it looks quite dirty because 3 weeks ago there were 3 typhoons strong. So a lot of buildings were destroyed. A lot of sand were moved away. And the girl which picked us up, she said it's quite dangerous to swim on this beach, exactly in this place, because it's deep right after you enter in the water and a very strong stream. So many people have drowned here. She said it's better to go to the beach with reef It's name of the beach, Reef Beach. These people are very nice. It's a sister and brother. We're stopping in all these places just for us to take video and pictures. Now we made a stop at Yuzhno-Morskoy. It's a town next to Livadiya. We found this nice spot with view on the sea and the beach. There are these comfortable benches. And we are having lunch, rice with egg, and boiling the water for tea. Tea with cookies. And this is just apartment houses.
I swam on this beach for the third time in the Japanese sea, and Xusha also decided to swim for the first time. Yeah, the water was really nice. We were swimming for half an hour, and now we will go to Vladivostok. So it was our last time on the Japanese sea. And the woman said us this water is canalization from the hospital.
Nice!
Some people have gardens here.
Today is 24th of September, and finally we left Vladivostok after more than a week staying in the city and around. And we are on the way back to St. Petersburg, but still we will visit many cities on the way back. Today we plan to stay in Khabarovsk for a night and continue to Chita. Here the weather is still nice, maybe plus 20-22 degrees, and just the day before we were swimming in the Japanese sea. So in Moscow it's already cold, and here is like summer. So this is the main road from Vladivostok to Khabarovsk. Да. So in Russia, as you can see, you can hitchhike in the place wherever you want. Police doesn't care, and people will stop for you anyway.
In the morning, we hitchhiked the car for 650 kilometers all the way to Khabarovsk. This man bought his car in Vladivostok, and now he drives back home. So we are together already for 8 hours, and soon we will arrive to Khabarovsk again.